Shalom, shalom. I'd like to start off by giving all praises, all honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to you brothers out there to the four corners of the earth, teaching in truth and sincerity. Okay? Now, what I have on the screen is, this is from Time Magazine, okay? And then what you see here is, you know, two devils, Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton. Now, we know Donald Trump just got elected for president, okay? Which means nothing, all right? Because America will still be destroyed, which is known as Babylon the Great in the scriptures, okay? But what I wanted to expound on is this photo that they have that Time Magazine has on the front cover, okay? And it says, the end is near, okay? Now, which you're absolutely right, all right? Now, what end are you talking about, okay? The end that we know for us and what the scriptures say and that will come to pass is what? The end of your world, okay? The end of you Edomites' rulership. And let's jump right into that. Because at the end of the day, we know nothing goes past the elites. So they push that magazine out there because they know. They know the Bible to be true, okay? They know through all history and these different things that will come to pass, that has happened inside the Bible, okay? And they, what is it? It's Revelation. I'm gonna have to get that first. Revelation, I think it's 12. Okay. Revelation 12 and 12. It says, therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil has come down unto you, having a great wrath, because he knoweth that he have but a short time. Okay. So these devils know they have a short time ahead of them, okay? Like the picture says, the end is near, okay? And it's going to be the end of your kingdom, okay? Which is the so-called white man, you Edomites. The end of your kingdom. The end of your rulership. The end of your wickedness, okay? Because it's going to come a time when Esau is going to pour all hell out on the people. And it's mainly going to be geared to you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Okay, because they know the truth. They know you are the Israelites of the Bible. Okay, so let's go back on topic. Okay, so now to finish expounding what I have here on the screen, just jump straight into the scripture. Second Esdras 6 and verse 7. It says, then answered I and said, okay, because this was Esdras was getting a lot of things revealed to him, okay? And this is one of the things that was revealed to Esdras, okay? Then answered I and said, what shall be the parting asunder of the times? Or when shall be the end of the first and the beginning of it that followeth? Okay, now this is what Esdras was asking the angel. And he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau. Okay. And that symbolized Jacob pulling Esau out of power. Okay. Which is happening before our eyes right now. Because their Esau is losing his power day by day, minute by minute. It says, Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau. For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. All right. Now it says, for Esau is the end of the world. Now, when you look into that word world in the Greek, it means aeon, okay? Which means age or rulership, okay? Not the end of the world, meaning won't no one ever live again, okay? Because how would Jacob be the beginning of it that followeth if that would be the end of the whole entire world? No, okay? So that's why you got to look into and study and look into the, what different words mean, okay? Because Esau like to play on words. So it says, for Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of that follow. Okay? So who's going to rule next after Esau? The Israelites. Okay? So we know Jacob's name got changed to what? Israel, after he wrestled with the angel. And we know he is the forefather. He's the one that had the 12 sons, which became the 12 tribes of Israel. Okay? So it's going to be our time to rule, which is coming next. And we're going to rule in righteousness. Okay? Starting off with a leader, you know, who is Yahushua, who the world ignorantly called Jesus. Okay? Then you'll have King David, you know? And there will be a order on down. All right, so with that, I'd like to say, Shalom.